I also want to remember Brother Abdul Malik Hamidullah. He was the operations manager for IANT at the time when the school opened, up into the second or third year when I was here. And I think second year I was here. And his he filled in all the gaps in the beginning when there was no school manager, there was no principal. We're just opening a school, and Abdul Malik never thought twice about whether this school was a part of INT or not, whether it needed things, how this organization would provide those things to our school and make sure that we had everything it needed. I'm not sure if we have thanked these people enough. It seems that when people work hard in a community organization, then we shouldn't be able to thank them enough. I also want to remember that she's here, to not forget her, Sister Maysoon Al-Khayali. She's the first employee of IQA. Sister Maysoon has been the pillar of the office from day one. She probably saw all of our resumes come through. She's the one that has, she has been the mother for the school, you can say. I can tell you also, though this will embarrass her perhaps, that she did this perhaps during a time in her life that was not easy for her. She had to go through a lot of difficulty and personal hardship, and this school maybe shouldn't have been the first thing on her mind, but in some way it was a blessing for her, and also she was a blessing for us. I want to remember also then, again, may Allah reward her. I would remember also many teachers and other teachers that have been with us, Dr. Anjum, Sheikh Gareed, Sheikh Sayed, Imam Arafi, all the other teachers, many teachers that have been through our walls and have served in various capacities and have helped to contribute to where we have come so far today. And moving on, I want to let us count our blessings. As Allah says that if you were to count God's blessings, you would not be able to number them. He is continuously forgiving, most merciful. So how much of a blessing is it to have a school like IQA? A school with a mission like IQA, where we are developing the next generation of American Muslim scholars. Where you come in the halls and you hear the hum of Quran all day long. Where ilm is being taught, and where other knowledge is being integrated in a way that we haven't seen for centuries. We don't consider these as separate courses from the ilm. We don't say that this is the Islamic subject, and that's not the Islamic subject. Because all knowledge is Islamic knowledge, if it's true knowledge. So how much of a blessing to have such a resource like this school in our community? What is our responsibility as Muslims in the United States of America to establish an institution like this, where the transference of Islamic knowledge and then the positive transformation of the society and the world would take place? Those of us so privileged, being Muslims here in this country, living a good life, having the ability to have a strong influence on the whole entire world. This is, I'm only echoing what the vision of our Imam has been, that this is our responsibility, to root the Islamic sciences here, the Islamic traditions here, and to let them take on the flavor of the culture here, so that we can have an authentic rooting of Islam in North America that can then reach out and have an influence over the whole world, like America is having influence over the whole world and other things. In the summer of 2004, when just before I came, someone else came that was our dearly respected Director of Religious Studies, Dr. Zafar Andrew. But when I arrived, he was in Mecca, standing at the Kaaba, making Umrah and praying for the success of this school. And alhamdulillah, he said himself, he felt his dua was answered, when maybe 6 months later, or a few more months later, in February, IQA announced its first two Hufaz. Many Yemeni in sixth grade who also her mother was a teacher with us. She also, her mother was also able to complete her memorization of Quran while working with us. Maybe there are some other mothers that have memorized so much Quran with their daughters, we just don't know about them. Umm Bakali, both of her parents, she is another Hafiza that we announced at that time. Both of her parents have served this community so well. We want to remember them and thank them. Her mother works in our Young Muslim program. Her father has worked in the IANT office taking care of the books. In 2007, our school became fully accredited by the Southern Association of Colleges and Schools. This validated what we were saying all along, that you were not just coming here for Hifz, but that all of the subjects we taught were meeting the same standards, that the school itself was meeting the same standards as any other public school, as any other accredited private school. And there would be no more validity to the claim that we just come for Hifz and we go to somewhere else. And if you think about it, I know why the challenge was there, because when you think about it, this is the only school in North America that is accredited where your child can memorize the Quran full-time. Every child memorized the Quran full-time while taking their accredited subjects. And then going on in their upper grades, beginning in 2006, we launched all courses. And now this year, at the end of May 2009, we have finalized the Alam curriculum, the Arabic curriculum for those courses, as Brother Shai mentioned earlier. And during this whole time, our students were winning competitions left and right, local competitions, national competitions, competitions in Hifz and Tajwid. And then this year in Scholastics, the PSIA was a scholastic competition between private schools. And the first year we even tried to compete in the local science fair, mashallah, our students were winners. Our students during this time, during this year, at the end of 2008, our students ranked in the 20th percentile, as the top 20% in the nation on their standardized tests. So when you put all of this in perspective, you see that we have striven to follow and live up to the hadith of the Prophet when he said that God has prescribed excellence in all things. Whatever you do, do it well. If I could ask you to give one more takbir and strong hand for all of our students. Takbir! I meant to say students and their parents, so takbir! Certainly this kind of effort, this kind of success comes with the full cooperation of everyone. Teachers, the community, the parents, and the students themselves that have given everything they had to become what we have asked them to become. These are the favors of our Lord that we cannot deny. A learning community based on teaching the Quran. How many families have moved here to become a part of this community? How many families of teachers, shuyukh, and other teachers of the other sciences that believe in our mission are being sustained by our tuition, by our scholarships, by our donors, in order to be able to sustain their families and dedicate themselves full-time to this noble mission. Isn't it worth every penny? Isn't it worth whatever the cost? When we say we are raising the next generation of American Muslim scholars, will you tell them that when they become scholars, where will you work? What will your pay be? What will your benefits package look like? Does it have to fit neatly into our budget, or is it something that We need their service. We need their youth to reach out to the youth. We need their familiarity with the culture to reach out to the American culture. Are we willing to pay this price?